Hello friends, in this video we shall see how MySQL database can be interfaced with our Python program. Python has an interface with almost all the database products that are prevalent today. For all the interfaces, Python's standard library prescribes a DBI standard called as DB-API. This DB-API is prescribing a set of standards for the database interfaces. This database API supports wide range of database servers like Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, SQLite and rest of others. So all these database products can be interfaced with Python if the interfacing module is following the DB API standard. DB API provides the minimal standards for working with the database. Now, it prescribes the method of performing these activities. First of all, in order to establish or in order to use that database, what you have to do is at the top of the script, import that API module. Whichever module you are using to interface with whichever database product, that must be imported in the beginning. Using the functionality in the module, acquire the connection with the database. Now, it may require certain login credentials like username, password, the IP address, etc. So that you have to provide. Once the connection is established, that means what? Your Python program is now able to communicate with the database server. Once this is in place, all you have to do is now use the or process upon the data that is stored in the databases. Usually the databases are the relational databases, and the relational databases are formed on the principle of storing the data in tables which are related together. And in order to perform different operations upon the data in the tables, there is a generic SQL language is used. SQL stands for Structured Query Language. So all these database products that I just named, like Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, SQLite, etc., they use some, you know, different or slightly different, slightly modified dialect of SQL, but essentially it is an SQL. So SQL prescribes the statements for performing insertion, deletion, updation, operation, etc. So all you have to do is to issue the proper SQL statement which is required for your program. Many of these database products that I have named provide the feature of writing stored procedures. A stored procedure is nothing but a program or a script in SQL. So a group of SQL statements, just like any other mainstream programming language SQL, this stored procedure can also have the conditionals and loops, etc., used in the stored procedures. So such stored procedure can also be executed. So that is the second step. Now, the execution of these SQL statements will generate a certain result, and that result will be known to the Python script from which you are doing all this. So the program, the Python program, will consume that result, do whatever process it has to perform on it, and lastly the connection that was opened in the beginning must be closed. Now, as far as MySQL is concerned, the earlier version of Python, the Python 2, up to Python 2.7 also, used to use the very popular module called as MySQL DB. But now in Python 3, that MySQL DB has not been ported to Python 3. So therefore, it cannot be used with Python 3. So what is the alternative? There is a PyMySQL module. which is more or less having the same functionality with respect to MySQL DB. So using the MySQL DB, your program, your Python program can be interfaced with a MySQL database. In the subsequent video, I will show you how to install the MySQL, PY MySQL module.